Hey everyone, this is Dom from Tech Advisor. I've just seen some of the cool tech Acer has been showing off as part of its global press conference. And the really exciting one is something they are dubbing SpatialLabs, which is essentially glasses-free 3D imaging that they're able to build into a laptop. We've seen this kind of tech before. The difference is this time it really, really, really works well. Okay, so. SpatialLabs is the name for a whole suite of tech that Acer is putting out. The first thing to clarify is there is currently no product. There isn't a laptop you can go and buy right now or anything like that. I've seen SpatialLabs running on a prototype device Acer has ready, but they say that sometime this year, they did say by the end of the year, they will be announcing the first products under the brand. They're probably going to fall under Acer's Concept D line, which is what it brands its creator-led devices, because that's really where they're positioning this. Not for consumers to go and watch 3D movies at home, because I think even Acer does recognize that market doesn't really exist anymore. Instead, this is for creators actually using 3D modeling software and stuff like that for their jobs, so that suddenly they can build a little 3D model and then see it in 3D from their screen in real time. So the way it works inside this prototype device we've seen here is that there's basically two core bits of physical hardware tech going on. The first is that there's actually an optical lens layer on top of the display, which basically means that when it is showing two images slightly offset side by side, it can combine them into one 3D, stereoscopic 3D image. This is the kind of stuff that those glasses do when you're watching something at the cinema or something, but here it's built directly into the screen of the laptop. Like I said, we've seen 3D tech before, we've seen glasses-free 3D tech before. The secret trick Acer has built in here is eye tracking. So you'll notice there's a set of eye tracking cameras above the screen of this laptop. So what they are doing is looking for where your eyes are so that they can exactly position the stereoscopic 3D image to where you are looking. That has a whole host of benefits. The most important one is you don't have to stay in the exact right spot to get the 3D image. There's still a kind of range you've got to stay within, but once you're within that range, you can bob your head from side to side, you can move a bit forwards and back. And the fun thing about that is that then when you have a 3D image popping out of the screen, you can actually kind of look around it a bit and turn your head around this 3D thing popping out and it will adjust. There's a little stutter, there's an adjustment period. It takes a couple seconds for the eye tracking to keep up with you, but it does actually work. From a software perspective, there's basically three things at play here. One is simple, they're just calling it SpatialLabs Player. That is a tool to play 3D footage, videos, any sort of 3D output, it can play it and then you can watch it in 3D. The second is what they're calling the SpatialLabs Model Viewer. This allows you to view models, funnily enough. They're building this in add-ons for like a whole suite of the most popular 3D modeling software. They've already got it up and running with Maya, which is one of the big ones. But basically, this is an add-on tool they're going to build in with these software partners so that if you are, like I said, building a 3D model, either say someone building one for a video game, for animation, I imagine architects and the like would absolutely have a use for this, or designers, product designers. So if you put your 3D model or something, you can then immediately just flip a switch and have it pop up in 3D and look at it that way, then turn it back off to go back to work in 2D. And the final one that's really cool is called SpatialLabs Go. And basically there's a little overlay they can use so that it can cleverly recognize stereoscopic content from other sources and turn it into 3D in front of you. So you may know that on YouTube, there's loads of kind of stereoscopic 3D content that if you try and watch on your normal screen, you're just seeing two images side by side and that's it. It's useless. You're just watching 2D, but twice replicated. But if you have this Go overlay, you can just hit the Go button and then suddenly it will figure out the stereoscopic content on the screen and convert it, do whatever magic it's doing behind the scenes and produce the 3D video that you're expecting to see. So that means suddenly you've actually got a way to access all this existing 3D content that's out there and watch it on your new 3D laptop screen. Like I said, there's no actual product yet. The laptop I've been trying it out on is just a prototype device. On here, it's working with a little like 14-inch laptop with a 4K display, so you're getting two 2K images for a total kind of 2K 3D image. I don't know if we're gonna see something that looks like this launch this year. You could imagine this could be in laptops. It could be in monitors. That would be a very obvious space for Acer to do it because they have Concept D monitors as well. I don't know if there's got something else up their sleeves. That also means I don't know about pricing. Expect this to be expensive. But again, this isn't really going to be consumer tech. This is going to be pitched towards the creative industries and people working in those spaces where they're already dropping thousands on pro-grade monitors, so throwing in a bit more for 3D tech maybe doesn't seem so outrageous at that point. And the final thing to note is it does work if you're wearing regular glasses, and just as importantly right now, it still works if you're wearing a face mask.